How's it going, guys? It's Red, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys a super powerful medic build that you guys can be using right now in Back 4 Blood. This setup should easily be able to get you guys through Recruit and Veteran, and this can also even be taken into Nightmare. But before we get into that, if you're new here to the channel, make sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe for more awesome Back 4 Blood content, just like this. Also, make sure to check out the link to my Discord server. It's going to be down in the description below. You guys can use it to find teammates to play Back 4 Blood with, so if you guys are in some dire need of teammates, make sure to come check out the Discord server. And without further ado, I hope you guys enjoy the video. Alright, so here we are in the deck building menu in Back 4 Blood. This is going to be the complete deck list, so if you guys are just looking to copy and paste, now is your time to do so. But I'm going to be spending basically the remainder of this video just talking about why every card is where it is and what role each card plays in the deck specifically. Now, the objective of this deck is quite simple. Since we are a medic build, we're just going to be healing our teammates as much as humanly possible and just making sure that their health is always up at all times. Now, we do have a few speed cards in this deck just to, you know, be able to zip around to our teammates even faster. Especially if they're a little spread out if you're trying to play with something like randoms. And we also have some unique ways to give some DPS out to our team, actually, so we can help them in more ways than one, you know, so we're not just a healer. Now, in the number one spot, we have Experienced EMT, which says when we use a medical accessory, the target gains plus 20% maximum health until the end of the level. Now, if you don't know why Experienced EMT is really good, it's because there's a little trick you can do at the beginning of every single level where you can open the door, have your teammates stand outside the door, and you can just shoot them once with the pistol and then give them all like a bandage or a pills or something like that. And for the rest of the level, they are going to have plus 20% of their maximum health just for no reason, other than the fact that you shot them and put a bandage on them. Now they have 20% more health. I mean, think about it, just for having this card, you're giving each other player a fifth of their health completely for free. This is by far the best card in the entire deck. Now at the number two spot, we have Run Like Hell, which gives us plus 15% move speed, but when we take damage, our accuracy is reduced by 20% for 3 seconds. Now the downside isn't that bad when you're like a doc medic build, and that's just because you aren't supposed to be DPS, you know what I mean? Like, it's not bad if you can't really kill anything because you're just doc. Your job is to make sure everyone's alive, so therefore your accuracy being reduced just a tiny bit, I mean, it's not that big of a deal. And the plus 15% move speed is particularly good when you're playing a medic build because you're kind of all over the place, you know what I mean? Like, I do think that you should be like at the core of all your teammates, but you also have to be able to go to any of your teammates at any time to make sure that you can heal them with whatever healing item you're going to use. And having increased move speed being faster than everyone else really helps with that. Now in the number three spot, we have Charitable Soul, which says healing a teammate also applies 50% of the effect to you. Now this is like the second best card in the deck in my opinion. The only reason it's in the number three spot is because I do think movement speed is really important, like more important than this. Now this card makes it so you most of the time don't have to heal yourself anymore. Like, you don't have to use bandages, first aid kits, pills, whatever. You don't have to use them on yourself anymore. Just healing your teammates, doing what Doc already is really good at, applies 50% of that effect to you. So if you give someone a med kit, you're gonna heal like 30 life, you know what I mean? Like, that's just absolutely insane. And I mean, it's just really gonna put a lot less stress on all of your medical accessories, because most of the time you're only gonna have in between like 2 to 4, and for like an entire mission, like some of the longer missions, that is very stressful to know when to use it, when not to use it, when to use your field dressings. And this just takes a lot of the stress off. Now something of note is that Charitable Soul does not count with your field dressings. So when you use your field dressings, which is Doc's ability, just once per turn you can give someone a free heal. Now Charitable Soul does not affect that, so when you use your field dressings, you are not going to get any health off that. Now in the number four slot is going to be Shoulder Bag, which gives us plus 2 inventory slots, but at the expense of minus 10% damage dealt. And let me tell you, this is a trade I would take all day, every day, because this is exactly where Doc wants to be. Because it's okay if Doc can't kill anything but common, you know what I mean? It's okay if she can't just laser down any of the special infected, because she's a medic. And getting plus 2 support slots, that is absolutely huge. That is 3,000 coppers worth of stuff that we get in one card just because we do a little less damage. Like, 10% isn't even that bad, you know what I mean? It's not like saying it's reducing half your damage. No, it's 10%. It's not that bad. In the number 5 spot, we have Field Surgeon, which gives us plus 60% healing efficiency with the expense of minus 50% use speed. Now, we have other cards to make our use speed faster so that we only can reap the reward side of healing efficiency. I mean, 60% healing efficiency is a lot, and it's basically all you need on top of Doc's already like plus 20% healing efficiency just for existing. Like, that's her static effect. So you'll have plus 80% healing efficiency, and honestly, you really don't need much more healing efficiency on top of this. In the number 6 spot, we have Combat Medic, which gives us plus 50% use speed, and it heals teammates for an additional 20 health when we revive them. Now, truthfully, this card is pretty much only in here because it makes Field Surgeon way better, because it makes it so that use speed debuff, it, you know, just doesn't exist anymore. And it does have a nice effect. Like, it is nice that we can heal teammates for 20 more health when we get them up. Like, that is nice, but the main reason is because of Field Surgeon. It's just that good. Now, at the number 7 spot, we have Rousing Speech, which gives us plus 225% revive speed, but it disables our offensive accessories. But as a team effect, we also get plus 20% reduced in-gap trauma. Now, I know disabling our offensive accessories seems like a bit too much, but I mean, think about it. What is Doc gonna do with a frag? You know what I mean? Like, at best, she can kill a tall boy with a frag or use a pipe bomb, but I mean, like, at the same time, when it comes to modes like Nightmare, you need to just fully commit to your role. Like, that revive speed is going to be absolutely critical, especially in the higher difficulties. And throwing on top that everyone gets way less trauma, like 1/5 less trauma when they go down, just for having this card as well. Like, that's also like a really, like, people forget about that, I think, just how really, really potent that effect is. Number 8 is going to be Medical Professional, which says first aids and defib units also recover 15 trauma damage and 1 extra life. Now, the main reason we put this in is because first aids recover a lot of trauma damage, and trauma damage is something that you are going to have to deal with in basically every difficulty of the game, but it gets very, very potent on Veteran and Nightmare. And I mean, yeah, you're going to have a lot of things like bandages that can heal a lot of your health, but that's just because most of your health is taken by trauma, and you need to be able to constantly take off this trauma, or eventually you're just going to be stuck having like 15 health as your max health because you have trauma everywhere else. You know what I mean? Like, you need to be able to stay at like 150 health like normal at all times. Number 9 is going to be Fanny Pack, which gives us plus 1 support inventory. It's just a worse shoulder bag, but I mean, like, getting an extra support is obviously really, really good, but the reason it's so low is because it's just a worse shoulder bag. Number 10 is going to be Support Scavenger, which says we sense nearby support accessories and more support accessories spawn. I mean, this one's just an auto include. I mean, like, we want more healing items to spawn so that, you know, our copper isn't as stressed to just always buy medical items, and like, that's it. Like, this is just helpful on so many levels. This one is just really, really good. Now, at the number 11 spot is Boxo Bags, which gives us minus 10 health but a team effect of plus 1 support team inventory. Now, I mean, Boxo Bags is just a worse fanny pack, and fanny pack is just a worse shoulder bag. Like, these are all still very powerful effects that I will take for, you know, a small debuff, but it's just the worst version of this. That's why it's lower in the list. And I mean, 10% isn't even that much. Now, number 12 is going to be Marked for Death, which says mutations you ping are highlighted and your team deals 10% increased damage to highlighted enemies. Now, this is a very unique way that I feel like docs can really just give a lot of DPS to their team, because I mean, most of the time docs are going to be in the back and they should be able to be one of the first members of the team to just be like, hey, there's a special infected right there, and then should ping them. And just for that, that special infected is going to take 40% more damage, assuming everyone shoots at him, which I mean, everyone should do. But I mean, even if just 2-player shoot him, that's 20% increased damage literally just for pinging. It's perfect for Doc because Doc is putting out a lot of DPS without actually doing anything, if that makes sense. Number 13 is going to be EMT Bag, which gives us plus 40% healing efficiency and minus 20% stamina efficiency. Now, the reason it's so low in the deck is because it's just, you know, like a worse version of this. I know I keep saying that, but I mean, just this deck just kind of has like a lot of redundant effects, and you just kind of play the better copies up top and the worst copies down low, and that's just what happened to EMT Bag. Like, we need that extra healing efficiency. Like, this comes in like in finales, you know what I mean, where people are going to be coming at you when they got like 3 health left and like full trauma bars and stuff like that. Like, you need to be able to basically just heal people's entire health bar in just 1 healing item, and I mean, with EMT Bag, it's completely possible. Now, at number 14, we have Mag Carrier. Now, depending on how you like to play Doc, Mag Carrier could easily be switched out for Stock Pouch, which is just the sniper version of this card. Now, there are two ways that you can play Doc weapons-wise. You can either play as like a speedy SMG build, or you can play as like a speedy kind of sniper build, where you only use the sniper to pop Special Infected after you've pinged them and they're taking 40% increased damage. Like, the sniper version of Doc is a version that can more reliably kill Special Infected, especially a lot quicker, whereas like the speedy SMG version of Doc is basically just going to be on common patrol the whole time, just making sure common stay off all your teammates while they're doing the more, you know, important stuff, killing all the Special Infected. Now, at number 15 is going to be Mad Dash, which gives us plus 20% sprint speed at minus 30% sprint stamina efficiency. Now, the reason that this is so low on the deck is because, like I said earlier, I do think that we need to be faster than everyone just because we need to be able to zip around and heal all of our teammates. But we don't really need more speed than what Run Like Hell gives us, except for something like a finale. Because, I mean, finales are purposely harder than everything else, you know what I mean? And you're just constantly going to have teammates taking way more damage than usual, so you're going to need to zip around everywhere just to be able to heal people, and I feel like just the regular Run Like Hell speed isn't gonna be enough. Like, you need Mad Dash. Well, that's gonna do it for the video, guys. Make sure to leave a comment down below telling me any deck changes that you guys would make, and as always, if you happen to enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more awesome Back for Blood content just like this. Also, make sure to check out the link to my Discord server. It's gonna be down in the description below. You guys can use it to find teammates to play Back for Blood with, so if you guys are in some dire need of teammates, make sure to come check out the Discord server. And until next time, it's been Red, and I'll see you guys in the next video.